हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज अंकिता राजपूत। दिस लेक्चर इज अ वेरी फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ आर न्यू कोर्स न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स, एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द बेसिक न्यूक्लियर प्रॉपर्टीज। ओके, सो लाइक न्यूक्लियर साइज, न्यूक्लियर चार्ज एंड मास रेडियस, न्यूक्लियर डेंसिटी एंड मैग्नेटिक मूवमेंट ऑफ न्यूक्लियस, एंड वी विल ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक क्वाड्रुपोल मूवमेंट ऑफ द न्यूक्लियस। ओके, as you all know, the nucleus is first discovered by a great Rutherford in 1911 by his famous experiment that is known as Rutherford experiment. And in his experiment he found that nucleus is a very small and dense region and having protons and neutrons at the center of the atom. Okay, like you can see, this is very dense and protons and neutrons are located inside the atom, at the center of this atom. Okay, so this nucleus, this atomic nucleus, is basically a bound quantum mechanical system, and as this is a quantum mechanical system, so it can exist in different quantum states, and these quantum states are characterized by different energies, angular momenta, and there are other factors also on which these quantum states basically depend. Okay, so if we talk about the atomic nucleus radius, Rutherford was the very first scientist jinhone ek idea diya that how to calculate and how to evaluate the value of atomic radius. Okay, so from his famous Rutherford experiment, which was performed in 1911, he estimates the value of atomic nucleus radius, but the problem is the value calculated by him was not accurate. Okay, so after him, there were many experiments. According to the experiments, one thing is concluded, and the thing was the nuclear mass density is nearly constant inside the nucleus. Okay, so jo mass density hai, nuclear mass density basically, wo throughout the nucleus nearly constant hoti hai, and as nuclear mass is proportional to mass number A, so nuclear mass density is constant, and this density is mass upon volume. Okay, so that means V is proportional to A. Okay, and because density is constant, that means simply V will be proportional to A. Volume is proportional to nuclear mass. Okay, so when we calculate the value of nuclear radius, we assume that the shape of the nucleus is spherical. Okay, it is spherical in shape. So V will be your the volume of the sphere, that is 4 by 3 pi r cube. So r is basically the radius of your nucleus, so this value will be proportional to A. Okay, and 4 by 3 pi is a constant, so simply r is proportional to A to the power 1 by 3. Okay, so that means R equals to R naught A ki power 1 by 3. So R naught is your constant, and this constant is known as nuclear radius parameter. Okay, so this R naught is your nuclear radius. Okay, and the value of R naught is 1.3 Fermi. Okay, Fermi is a very small unit, and 1 Fermi equals to 10 to the power minus 15 meter. Okay, so in this formula you can calculate the value of R, that is the nuclear radius, for different nucleus. Okay, while calculating the value of nuclear radius, the problem was that both the atoms and nuclei, they don't have some definite boundaries. Okay, neither atom nor nuclei, they don't have definite boundaries. So to calculate the value of atomic nuclear radius is not very easy. Okay, so for calculating the values of nuclear radius, we have to take two interpretations, two different interpretations. Okay, so first is nuclear charge radius. Okay, so first assumption is we can conclude that our nucleus is basically a sphere, and this sphere is basically containing positive charge. Okay, so in first assumption, what we consider? We consider that atomic nucleus is basically a sphere of positive charge, okay? And by using a few experiments like electron scattering method and muon scattering method also, by using these methods, scattering method, we calculated nuclear charge radius, okay? So, by considering the assumption of charge distribution inside the nucleus, scientists calculated the value of radius, and this radius, nuclear radius, is known as nuclear charge radius, okay? And the value of this radius will be 1.2 Fermi, okay? So, second assumption is based on the mass distribution inside the nucleus, okay? And due to this, this radius is known as nuclear mass radius and also nuclear potential radius, okay? So, how the mass of nucleons is distributed throughout the whole nucleus, and the scientists took this factor into account, and using some scattering methods like neutron scattering methods, they calculated the value of nuclear mass radius, and they calculated that R0 is 1.3 to 1.7 Fermi. ओके सो सिंपली अगर आप कंसीडर करते हैं कि आपका जो न्यूक्लियस है दैट इज बेसिकली ए स्फेयर ऑफ पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड उस तरह से अगर आप कुछ एक्सपेरिमेंट्स लेके चलते हो जैसे इलेक्ट्रॉन स्कैटरिंग हो गया आपका म्यून स्कैटरिंग मेथड्स हो गया तो उन मेथड्स को यूज करके आपने न्यूक्लियर चार्ज रेडियस कैलकुलेट किया एंड दैट वॉज 1.2 फर्मी ओके सेकेंड इंटरप्रिटेशन में आपने देखा कि न्यूक्लियस के अंदर मास डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन किस टाइप से होता है एंड उस पॉइंट को कंसीडर करके आपने यूज किया न्यूट्रॉन स्कैटरिंग मेथड्स को एंड देयर मे बी सम अदर स्कैटरिंग मेथड्स आल्सो एंड दे कैलकुलेटेड दैट न्यूक्लियर रेडियस पैरामीटर इज 1.3 टू 1.7 फर्मी सो सिंपली न्यूक्लियर मास रेडियस इज ग्रेटर देन न्यूक्लियर चार्ज रेडियस ओके सो एज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द बेसिक न्यूक्लियर प्रॉपर्टीज राइट हम बेसिक न्यूक्लियर प्रॉपर्टीज के बारे में बात करें सो ऑब्वियसली वी शुड ऑल्सो नो अबाउट द डेंसिटी ऑफ दिस न्यूक्लियस ओके आपने रदरफोर्ड एक्सपेरिमेंट पढ़ा होगा ही सेड दैट न्यूक्लियस इज ए वेरी स्मॉल एंड डेंस रीजन राइट सो लेट सी हाउ डेंस द न्यूक्लियस इज सो वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूक्लियर डेंसिटी वन इज न्यूक्लियर मास डेंसिटी And second will be nuclear particle density. So, this one is nuclear mass density. So, inside the nucleus, density of atomic nucleus is known as nuclear density. Okay, we are talking about the mass density here. So, and how we can calculate this nuclear mass density? By using the size or volume of the nucleus, we can calculate nuclear mass density. Okay, so... Nuclear mass density will be mass of nucleons divided by volume of the nucleus, right? So, if we have the mass number of atom is A, so total mass of the nucleus will be A multiplied by Mn, okay? This Mn is the mass of the neutron, okay? So, divided by B, okay? So, your nuclear mass density will be A multiply by Mn upon V. V is the volume of the nucleus. So, Mn is basically mass of the neutron and this is equal to mass of the proton and the value is 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg, right? So, value of V will be 4 by 3 pi r cube because we are taking a nucleus as a sphere. Okay, so we can put the value of R as R0 A to the power 1 by 3. Okay, so this will be Mn upon 4 by 3 pi R0 cube. Okay, also we know that a value of R0 is 1.3 Fermi. Okay, ideally, so put the all the values here. Mn will be 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27. Okay, pi is 3.14 and... R0 is 1.3 Fermi. So, for Fermi, we take 10 to the power minus 15. Okay. So, just solve the value. You get 10 to the power 17 kg per meter cube. So, your nuclear mass density is equal to 10 to the power 17 kg per meter cube. Okay, so you can see this is a very, very huge amount. Okay, so yeah, obviously Rutherford was right that nucleus is a very, very dense region, right? Now we will see the nuclear concentration, which is basically nuclear particle density. Okay, so the number of nucleons per unit volume of nucleus is your nuclear particle density, and this is represented by N, and N will be nuclear density upon mass of nucleus. Okay, so your N will be rho by Mn. So rho is your nuclear mass density and Mn is the mass of neutron or proton. Okay, so basically Mn is the mass of nucleon. So put the value of rho, that is 10 to the power 17 kg per meter cube, and your Mn is 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. So your N will be 10 to the power 44 per meter cube. So you can see there are so many nucleons inside the nucleus. Okay, so this is 10 to the power 44 nucleons per meter cube. Okay, so we calculated two values of two different types of nuclear radius based on two different assumption. Okay, like nuclear charge radius and nuclear mass radius. Okay, so now we will see how the charge inside the nucleus is distributed. Okay, so the experiments which were used to calculate the value of nuclear charge radius, these experiments also described the variation of charge inside the nucleus. Okay, so using these experiments, they collected some data, and this data is basically describing the variation of charge radius as a function of distance from the center of radius. Okay, so based on this data, the graph is plotted between nuclear charge density and radial distance. Okay, so this is rho naught. Okay, and also you can take rho here, simply nucleus charge density. Okay, and this is your radial distance, means the distance from the center of nucleus. Okay, so you see the charge distribution obeys this type of behavior. Okay, so you can see up to some distance this nuclear density is following a constant value. Okay, there is some constant trend, and after some point it falls gradually, okay, up to zero. So this is the behavior of nuclear charge distribution inside the nucleus. So you can conclude a few points here, like first thing is the charge is constant up to a certain distance, right? Second thing, after a particular value, the charge density gradually falls to zero, right? Okay, so based on this data, you can fit this data by this formula. The formula is rho equals to rho naught upon 1 plus e to the power r minus r upon a. Okay, if you know or remember this famous formula, this is the famous Wood section formula. Okay, so this is not calculated or observed formula, basically. Don't be confused. This is just a formula, and this formula fit the value of this data. Okay, so this is a Wood section formula, and the behavior of the charge density, it is constant up to a certain distance, then it falls gradually. Okay, so this behavior is best fitted by this formula. Okay, Wood section formula. So your rho naught is the maximum value of charge density, means at the center of your nucleus. Okay, and this r is the radial distance, and this capital R, okay, this capital R is basically the value of r, small r, at the point where the charge density is half. Okay, you can see this is 0.5, and at this point the value of small r is denoted by capital R. Okay. One more thing, this A. Okay. This A is a constant. And basically this A tells that how fast or maybe how slow this charge density falls from maximum value. Okay. So from here, charge density falls. So this A tells how fast this charge density drops. Okay. And this T, there is a relation between T and A. This is T. Okay. So T is 4.4A. Okay. So this is a very important graph, and you can many times you can find questions based on this charge distribution. Okay. Okay. So one more thing in nuclear basic properties is nuclear magnetic dipole moment. Okay. So like you have heard about the magnetic moment of electron, right? तो जैसे इलेक्ट्रॉन का मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट होता है, वैसे ही न्यूक्लियस का भी एक इंट्रिंसिक मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट होता है. एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ न्यूक्लियर मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट दैट इज म्यू एन इज ई एच अपॉन 4πmp. ओके. सो ई इज योर चार्ज एंड एच इज प्लैंक कांस्टेंट, 4π इज कांस्टेंट एंड एमपी इज बेसिकली द मास ऑफ प्रोटोन. ओके. सो दिस इज EH upon 4πmp is known as nuclear magnetic moment. Okay. So, and also mu n is also known as nuclear magneton. Okay. So, agar aapko yaad ho, if you remember that Bohr magneton, okay, Bohr magneton is represented by mu b, and it is EH upon 4πmp. It is basically the magnetic moment of electron. So, like nuclear magneton, it is related, it is analogous or similar to Bohr magneton. Okay. So you can calculate the value of mu n, nuclear magnetic moment, and the value of nuclear magnetic moment or simply nuclear magneton is 5.05 × 10⁻²⁷ joule per tesla. Okay. And the value of Bohr magneton is 9.28 × 10⁻²⁷ joule per tesla. Okay. So it's clear that nuclear magnetic moment is very, very smaller than electric magnetic moment, right? So proton and neutron, they also have some intrinsic magnetic moment. Jaise electron ke paas intrinsic magnetic moment hota hai. So your magnetic dipole moment of proton is 2.79 mu n, and magnetic dipole moment of neutron is −1.91 μn. Okay. Okay. So now we will discuss about the electric quadrupole moment of nuclei. Okay. So this is very interesting topic, I guess. This parameter, this electric quadrupole moment, is basically defines the shape of nuclear charge distribution. Okay. We have heard, we also studied about the nuclear charge distribution inside the nucleus. So उस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के बेसिस पे ही आपका शेप डिसाइड होता है न्यूक्लियस का. एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक क्वाड्रुपोल मोमेंट हेयर, इट टेल्स यू द शेप ऑफ दैट न्यूक्लियर चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, राइट? सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ क्वाड्रुपोल मोमेंट बाय यूजिंग डिफरेंट मैथड्स, लाइक इट्स क्लासिकल फॉर्म विच इज बेसिकली नोन एज इंट्रिंसिक क्वाड्रुपोल मोमेंट ऑफ न्यूक्लियस, एंड ऑल्सो द क्लासिकल electric quadrupole moment of nucleus. Okay. And it is represented by Q naught, and it is integration of rho 3z square minus r square dv. Okay. But the most importantly, the quantum mechanical representation of electric quadrupole moment is 3k square minus i plus 1 upon i plus 1 2i plus 3 q naught. Okay. So this k is some projection in z direction, and this I is nuclear spin. Okay. So this is basically the q we were talking about. The value of q defines the shape of nuclear charge distribution. Okay. So if we take the ground state of nucleus, if our nucleus is in the ground state, so simply the value of nuclear spin will be k. Okay. So simplify this term. So q will be i 2i minus 1 upon i plus 1 2i plus 3 q naught. Okay. So this is the value of electric quadrupole moment. Okay. after simplification. Okay, so we were talking about that this Q defines the shape of the charge distribution inside the nucleus, right? So if this Q is zero, that means the charge distribution is spherical in shape. Okay, if this Q having a non-zero value, that means charge distribution is non-spherical in shape. Okay, so from this formula you can find that the value of Q will be zero if I is zero, okay, and if I is 1/2. Okay, so if I is zero, your Q will be zero, one thing. Second, right, okay, and I when your I will be zero, when you have a even nuclei, right? So for even nuclei, we have I equals to zero, nuclear spin equals to zero, and simply Q bhi aapka zero ho jayega, okay. And second thing, for I equals to 1/2, aapka Q tabhi bhi zero hoga. So a non-zero value of Q shows that charge distribution is not spherically symmetric, right? ओके, सो हमने पढ़ा कि चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन स्फेरिकल नहीं होता कब, जब आपका क्यू नॉन जीरो होता है, राइट? सो हमारे पास यहाँ पे टू पॉइंट्स हो सकते हैं, लाइक क्यू ग्रेटर देन जीरो भी हो सकता है, ओके, मींस पॉजिटिव भी हो सकता है, एंड क्यू आपका नेगेटिव भी हो सकता है, लेस देन जीरो भी हो सकता है. तो इफ यू हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू ग्रेटर देन जीरो मींस पॉजिटिव, सो द चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, द शेप ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विल बी लाइक दिस. ओके, यू विल हैव इलिप्सॉइड, एंड विच टाइप ऑफ इलिप्सॉइड? प्रोलेट इलिप्सॉइड. ओके, सो दिस टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर और इलिप्सॉइड यू विल बी हैविंग, और न्यूक्लियस, द शेप ऑफ न्यूक्लियर चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विल बी लाइक दिस इफ द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू इज पॉजिटिव. ओके, सेकेंड थिंग, if q is negative less than 0, so the distribution will be like this. Okay, means oblate ellipsoid. Okay, so this is very easy and also very interesting about the electric quadrupole moment. Okay, so now we will discuss few problems from previous year NET question papers. So first problem is the radius of a copper nucleus having 29 atomic number and 64 mass number is measured to be 4.8 into 10 to the power minus 13 centimeter. So the radius of a magnesium nucleus, 12 atomic number and 27 mass number, the radius can be estimated to be, okay, so you have four options. So this is very easy, right? You have to calculate nuclear radius of magnesium. Okay, so simply you have to use this formula of nuclear radius, R equals to R naught a to the power 1/3, right? So for copper nucleus, RCU will be, the radius of copper nucleus will be R naught ACU by 1/3, right? And similarly for magnesium nucleus, you can write RMG equals to R naught AMG to the power 1/3. Okay, so just divide these two equations and you will get RCU upon RMG equals to ACU to the power 1/3 upon AMG to the power 1/3. So put the value of RCU, आपको given है यहाँ पे copper nucleus की radius, that is 4.8 into 10 to the power minus 13 centimeter. Okay, आप उसकी value put कर दीजिए. And you know the value of ACU and AMG, आप उनका values put कर दीजिए, तो ये आपका simply हो जाएगा 4/3. Okay, just solve, RMG आपका हो जाएगा 3.7 into 10 to the power minus 13 centimeter. Means आपका option C is correct. Okay, so our next problem is, for a nucleus to possess quadrupole moment, you have to find the correct option. Four options are here. First is I equals to 0, second I equals to 1/2, and third I is greater than 1/2, and fourth option is spherical shape of nucleus. Okay, we just studied about the quadrupole moment. The quadrupole moment of a nucleus is I 2i minus 1 upon I plus 1 2i plus 3 q naught. Okay, so if a nucleus is having quadrupole moment, means it should have a non-zero value of quad-pole moment. Okay, so we know the value of Q is zero if I equals to zero, I equals to 1 by 2, and also for spherical nucleus, the value of Q is 0. Okay, so option 1, 2 and option 4 are not correct option. Okay, and second thing, we should have the value of some value of Q, means Q should be non-zero, and it is possible only when the value of I is greater than 1 by 2. Okay, only for this condition here, Q will be non-zero. Okay, so for the nucleus to have quad pole moment here, I should be greater than 1 by 2. Okay, that means option C is correct. Okay, so the third problem is the mean momentum of a nucleon in a nucleus with mass number A varies as. Okay, so this is very interesting problem because it combines two different stream of physics, means quantum mechanics as well as nuclear physics. Okay, so this is basically the combined problem of nuclear physics and quantum mechanics. So you know the value of nuclear radius is R equals to R naught A by 3. Okay, so you need to calculate the value of mean momentum, means delta P. Okay, so we will consider the value of mean momentum of a nucleon inside the nucleus is delta P. Okay, so now we will use the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, because from that formula or principle we can calculate and we can find the value of delta P. Okay, so this Heisenberg uncertainty principle tells that delta X delta P is greater than equals to h cut by 2. Okay, so from here we can find the value of delta P, that is mean momentum. So delta P is greater than or equals to h cut by 2 delta X, right? Now we take delta X as R radius. Okay, so we are talking about nucleus, so we can take this position, mean position, as radius. So your delta P will be, and also we are taking the nearly equal to sign here. Okay, so mean momentum is nearly equal to some constant, because h cut is constant, 2 is also constant, so this will be constant upon R. Okay, so R we can take as R naught A to the power 1 by 3. So simply delta P will be proportional to A to the power minus 1 by 3. Okay, so inside the nucleus, the mean momentum of nucleon will be proportional to A to the power minus 1 by 3. Okay, so that means your option D is correct option. So thanks for watching the video. If you like the video, you can also share the video. And if you want to know anything about this topic, you can also ask in comment section. Thank you.